They gave a third of the money to the poor, a third of the temple, and only kept a third to themselves. But they had no children, and they were very sad about that. And Joachim went to the high priest, and the high priest said, "You're a sinner, because if you look at scripture, you'll see every righteous person has children, and we don't have any children." And Joachim was distraught, and he was very old by then. And he went up into the mountains. There was a cave. I was in the Holy Land. I was in this cave. You have to walk along this porch to get to it. It's where Isaiah is at. And he went there. It's quite a long ways from where he lived. It's very long. And he went there and prayed. And then Gabriel came to him and told him, "You'll have a child." And he was returning home at the same time, saying Anna had the same visitation. And he came home and they decided that whether they had a boy or a girl, they would dedicate that child to God and Mary. And when she was a little girl, they took her to the temple, where there was like a kind of a living school to make sure they were girls. And that's where she was raised. So at the time of, we have up here the icon of the Annunciation, there's Gabriel up there telling Mary she's going to have a child. That's her in the temple. Her role in the temple was a spin cloth. So we see her with the spindle. And up there it says the Annunciation of the Mother of God. And the church gives Mary that name, Mother of God, to denote actually Christ's humanity and divinity, that he was mother, that he was God. So she's had that name that title for a long time, Mother of God, Theotokos. So that icon is not always up there. It may be on the door also, like it is here. And sometimes in the doors we have the four gospel writers, or the four gospel writers will be on four corners, which will probably happen soon. Below Gabriel and Mary, because the church is dedicated to Mary's birth, we have her parents, Joachim and Anna. And then below that we have Peter and Paul, who are pillars of the church. Sometimes you'll see them on a pillar, or sometimes they'll be depicted elsewhere, but we have them there. And this icon here is called Wide Open Heavens, Mary with Jesus as a baby. It's very typical in the Orthodox Church. Just about every Greek church has them, and some of the Slavic churches